Hiya, Pidge here, and we're going to be playing some Eternal Winter. And this is a brand new game by Developers Pack. And the game focuses on a nuclear winter or some type of extreme winter that has happened. And it's basically you all alone with a team of dog sled. This game is very, very early alpha. In fact, this game, I've been given an early press release on the 22nd, and that's when we're recording this. But the game actually comes out for early alpha on the 24th. The game will initially be $9.99, but for the first week there will be a 20% discount, so the game will be $7.99. I highly suggest putting into this game and go ahead and spending the game and getting it early, because I just kind of foresee this game becoming something really cool. I like it. I really like the concept behind it. And we're going to kind of get right into it, and you guys will see kind of what we're talking about. Right now, the game is, of course, very early, so there's not just a whole lot of content, because the focus, of course, is on concept right now. So we want to start a new game. We started one earlier, but we want to go ahead and start a new game. Alright, start off, you get to name your dogs, so let's name our dogs. Let's go with Nerd Rock. Then next, let's go with Capern. Then we'll go with Shade. Oh, caps lock. And then lastly, let's go with Yip. Some friends of mine from Good Times. Let's start this off. Alright, starts off with a little menu right there. You guys can pause and read over that if you'd like. Alright, what are we starting out in here? What do we got? Can't tell what that is. I think that's a magazine. Yeah, magazine. We don't have a gun to shoot it with, but good. Get some bandages. Let's go ahead and use our flashlight. We do have a flashlight. Which at this point does not have any type of battery life or anything. Matches, that's definitely going to come in handy. Anything in the storage here? No. Matches come in handy. You find a little spot like this, you can light it up and get a little bit of warmth. I'm not exactly sure. There is supposed to be a temperature gauge. Right now you'll see in the bottom left we have food, water, and health. I know there is going to be a focus on temperature. I don't see where that's at, but we will pay attention to that. Also, we want to note that the only way to save currently is to sleep in a bed. I would like to see eventually in the future some type of maybe portable sleeping bag or something that you can carry around with you. That would be really cool. I really love the art style of this game. Which, of course, this is early alpha, so very basic textures. A lot of repeated textures and repeated buildings and that kind of thing. But within it still, I like the art. Here's our dogs. Nerd Rock, Capern, Yip and Shade. And you see the dogs, that the dogs have health, food, and I think the blue one is stamina. And you can interact with your dogs. You can feed them raw meat, feed them cooked meat, bandage, med pack. You can give them water, and you can also talk with them. I guess maybe keep up the morale of your dogs. There you go. So let's see what we got in our inventory right now. We've got some bandages, the food and drinks. We found the candy bar. We've got some water. Awesome, and we started off with a little bit of meat. You do have a weight limit you have to keep an eye on. Miscellaneous, we have a magazine and some matches, guns and tools. We have our compass. The compass, let's go ahead and do that. The compass, you pull this up and you hit M, and it'll set a waypoint for you. And so if you have a place that you want to, you know, technically call your home, that you can kind of set back to that. So let's go ahead and unequip that. You do have a small storage system in your sled that you could use. So without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on our sled here. Alright. And a lot of this I'll probably cut away for the dog sledding, just because this world is vastly huge, and there's a lot of just riding on the dog sled. But for the first part of it, I'm gonna kind of just hold on there and show you guys, kind of give you guys just an idea of how big this is. Of course, as you're going throughout the wilderness, you do come upon various threats. The threats at this point are very natural. You have wolves, bears, boars. There are a lot of passive animals as well, such as deer and foxes, that you can kill for food, as you were. Right now, we currently don't have any weapons on us, but you do have a type of punch. There's no animation or indication of that, but I have found that you can click on a threat and slowly punch its health away. We got a building up here that we're going to check for resources. But the concept of this game I really love, and really it's mainly the dog sled that sold me on it. I love survival games, of course, but they're kind of a dime a dozen now, and they're all very similar, and a lot of things are just alike. Do we got anything in here? Let's see. Nothing there. Nothing there. All right, moving along. But I like the dog sled because it's different. It's gives you a sense of responsibility. You're not just taking care of yourself, but you're also taking care of your dogs. And of course, we all have that innate thing in us to want to take care of our animals. And so you do got to protect them. You got to feed them, take care of them, protect them. The various threats will not only come and try to attack you, but they will try to attack your dogs as well. And so you have to protect them. You can, of course, harm your dogs yourself. Of course, I wouldn't suggest it, but that is possible. So you want to be careful and watch for misfire and things like that. But I really like the concept of the dogs. Big plans for this game. One of them being, of course, co-op is one of the main focuses that they're going to be looking forward into. And it will be, from the developer's opinion, it wants to be mainly PvE. Not looking at any sort of PvP at all. Because this game is going to be and it currently is a permadeath game, which means that once you die, that's it. You're dead. There's no respawning. And the idea behind it is, in a co-op situation, when you're playing as a team, that if one of your team members dies, then you all die. And so you're relying on each other for safety. You're relying on each other. Where are we going? I'm not seeing anything. We may be approaching a lake. I think we are, so we're going to go ahead and turn. Yeah, we are. So you have to rely on each other for protection and safety, as well as your dogs. And so, game's got a great feel to it. Again, I like the art style. To me, it honestly feels a lot like a cross between... you know, of course, Unturned with the looting system and the art style, but kind of a Salt feel, if you guys have played Salt at all. Whereas, you know, if you're playing Salt, you're on a boat, and there may be times when you're just traveling, and it seems like forever. And it's the same thing with this, of the world is so huge, as you guys can already tell, that there's times when you're on your sled for a while, and that taxes on not only your patience, but the stamina of your dogs as well. So that's something that you have to keep an eye on. Speaking of which, let's go ahead and stop and check on our dogs. Oh man, they're workhorses. So their food's gone down, stamina's gone down a little bit, but they're still good to go. So continuing on. Alright, looks like we got some buildings up there. Doesn't appear to be any form of background music at this point. I don't know if there are any plans to be or not, but it's very, very quiet at times, which I'm sure as the game develops, there may be some things such as background music and, of course, ambient noises such as wind and weather and that kind of thing. Of course, right now, the only noises that I've noticed so far is, you know, the sled, the dogs and animals, of course, and then footsteps. Let's go check out on this boat right here. Of course, the water is frozen, so we're not getting anywhere on this boat. Oh, sweet, we get the crossbow. That's awesome. Really early on to find that, and that is really good. So let's go ahead and equip that. Let's see how many arrows we got. 4. Alright, let's equip this thing up. See in the bottom right, we see our arrow count. Let's go ahead and reload with R. Head back up to our sled and check out this next building. You do have an aim. Kind of a zoom in kind of thing, and I believe, yeah, you can't fire your weapon unless you are zooming in. I would like to see, you know, at this point there's not any form of arrow retrieval. I would like to see that, you know, if you find the crossbow, that there's a chance of retrieving your arrows from the animals that you've killed. Nothing in there. And so I would like to see that in the future. I think that would be cool. Alright, we've got a deer up here, so I'm going to stop and see if we can kill this deer. I know if we get too close, there's no crouch or sneak at this moment, and I'm not exactly sure what the range is, so we don't want to get too close, but let's see. Oh, wow. Let's reload. See if we can kill this deer. Sauce. All right, and of course, as far as arrow retrieval, just skipping on. Probably wait till we can find the rifle to try to take that on. But let's go see if we get any kind of arrow retrieval from that. Oh, now he's just mocking us. He's seen us miss twice, and he's like, "Ha, you jerk." I like how you get a free look around when you're riding the dog sled. I think I saw my arrows go over this way. But as far as I know, there's not any form of arrow retrieval. So moving on then. Got a building right here. Let's check this out. And are we back at the lake again, looks like? Yes. Oh, we got another boat down there. See what we can find. Anything in here? Nope. There is a sprint, and I am of course, very impatient, so I want to use it a lot, but it uses up your calories, which is your food, very, very quickly. And so you want to try to stay away from doing that. I may be wrong, but it seemed like earlier... Oh! It seemed like earlier that if I were to jump, do the good old Minecraft sprint, where you sprint and jump, that if I sprint and jump, it seems to use stamina a little less, which will probably be fixed. But for now, I'll take advantage of it. Alright, so we just got a candy bar. That's it. So let's go ahead and move on. Alright, we've been sledding for a very long time. I'd probably say at least five to 7 minutes or so. We finally came up on something and want to check it out. So it looks like we've got something right there. So let's go ahead and stop here in the middle. Wow. Alright, so looks like we got some trucks. It's pretty cool. You can tell everything's really been ravaged by the winter. Awesome. We got an axe. Cool. Really good to have a melee weapon, of course. Can we get on the truck? Maybe? Doesn't look like it. Okay, so let's see what's in here. And we've got a box of cereal. And what are these? Just trucks? Let's see if there's anything in the... Can we get in the back of the trucks? Maybe? Let's go find out. And the answer is yes. Wow. Okay. Nothing in that one. What about this one over here? Nope. Alright. I'm anxious to see what all else might be in the game as far as hostile environments. Or if it's just going to retain the natural... Oh, here's something. What do we got here? Matches. Or if it's just going to retain the natural enemies and things. Alright. Moving on. Alright, what do we got here? I can't crouch. There's no form of crouching or anything yet. Can we go through this? Nope. Where's the door? Oh, right there. Alright, what do we got? We got a candy bar, and I believe that is a soda. Cool. And actually, we're kind of hungry and thirsty, so let's go ahead and take care of that. Let's go to our food and drink. And what do we got? A can of beans. Okay, so that restores 616, 200, 400, cereal does 300, 100 calories, and 25% hydration. Alright, and hydrated 35%. Alright, so let's drink the soda. Nice. Let's go ahead and heat up these candy bars. We need our carbs. Also noted that you cannot currently eat the raw meat. You have to, but if you cook it, it will go in your inventory and you can then eat it. Let's eat the beans. There we go. That filled us up quite a bit. Let's go ahead and save the cereal. Alright, and let's check on our dogs. Starting to get a little bit hungry, but we want to save that meat for just a little while. Considering that it's our only four pieces. So, let's save that for a little while until we find something else to use. Hopping on our sled, and moving on. Alright, I see a wolf over here, so let's go over and check this out. And once we get pretty close, he's going to start heading towards our dogs. Alright, so... Uh-oh. Hurry up, pull up a crossbow. Reload. Oh, I think our dogs attacked him too. Cool. The thing is huge. Alright, let's skin it. Haha, awesome. Alright, Capern lost a little bit of health there. Everybody else seems to be okay. That's okay. He took one for the team. Alright, let's see how many meat did we get off that. Alright, so we still got 6 meat. Let's go ahead and bandage up Capern here. He seems to like that. I haven't really discovered if it's going to be best to stick to the roads or kind of off the beaten path. I see some buildings over there, but then there's also something over there, and it's hard to know where to go or what to check out. This game is so huge as far as exploration. So many different places to go. Not exactly sure where to stick to, so I'm going to kind of follow the roads and check these buildings out over here. See something off there in the distance. And we'll see what we can find. Alright, let's see what we got in the back of these cars here. Empty, empty. Empty. Come on, don't leave me disappointed. Alright, we got some beans. There's not like an icon or system when you're looting. You'll just kind of see it just says beans. So, cool. We found some. Came all the way to the top of this and found some beans. I don't know if the map is randomly generated or if it's kind of a default map system. I kind of feel like it probably is. Oh, sweet, more arrows. Kind of feel like it is some type of a default map system. And if that is, then, you know, it gives us a chance to kind of learn the area and that kind of thing. So, cool deal. Alright, moving on. Okay, so we've stopped. It seems our dogs are too tired. So, that's what happens when the dogs... So let's go ahead and try to feed them, see if that helps any. So let's give you a piece of meat. And how about you? You. And lastly, yip. Alright, good dogs. Looks like their stamina is still kind of low. Alright, they look pretty tired, so let's see, can we go? Yeah, we can go a little bit. I want to check out this building over here. I've came across this building, or a building like this before, and seemed to have some pretty good stuff in it, so I want to check it out. And we'll give our dogs a little bit of time to rest too. Got another cop car. And let's check this out, see what we got here. Anything back here? Cereal. Okay. Quit sprinting. I want to sprint so bad. Chocolate. Chocolate! And in here. Awesome, we got 2 more boxes of cereal, I think. And some beans. Alright, so we got doing pretty good on food, so let's go ahead and eat. Yeah, let's go ahead and eat some cereal here. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Alright, what do we got, what do we got? Another building over there, so let's go check that out. And eventually, we're gonna need to find. We're gonna need to find somewhere with a bed. Just sleep and give our dogs a rest. Got turned around there. Nothing. Alright. Well, sorry, dogs, but we need to move on. Awesome. Okay, so that appears to be a thirst, and maybe that tends to... Oh, they're gonna pee. Okay, so that's, maybe that helps with the stamina. Sweet. Right over the corner, we seem to have found a place. Awesome. So let's stop here, guys. We're gonna rest here for the night. And yes, there is a bed. Awesome. Anything in there? Anything around here? Doesn't seem to be anything. What about in here? Nope, can't look at that. Alright, so let's start this up. Get a little bit of fire going. And let's rest. Let's go ahead and let's get us a good 8 hours. Tip, it is advised to light a fire before sleeping. This way you will not spend too many calories while you sleep. Okay, so I guess maybe that's where the cold comes in. It's through your calories. Good, good. Alright, we slept 8 hours. I think our dogs are good to go. Oh, they've gotten hungry. And what do we have? We have just a little bit of meat. And I don't want to feed two of them without feeding the other two. So let's move on and see what we can find. Got a fox. Oh, sweet, we found the rifle. Cool. Anything in here? We got some cereal and some water. Awesome. Matches. And let's go ahead and sleep so we can save our game. Cool. Let's go ahead and, let's see. Do we have ammo? Yeah, we have ammo. Let's go ahead and equip that rifle. Awesome. How's the aiming on that? Cool. Now we just need to find a deer or something and get some meat for our dogs. Okay, sweet. We've got a bear, so we're going to reload our gun. And let's go take on Mr. Bear over here. Which looks like he's kind of... Oh, wow. Haha. That's right. That's right. Alright, let's harvest this bear. Love that skinning sound. How much meat did we get? Awesome. We got 4 meat just off that bear, so let's go feed our dogs. And then move on a little bit further, and I think the next thing we want to do is maybe try to find another threat, which the threats are very few and far between, but which may actually be a good thing, but... Anyway, I would like to see how the death works in this game. Which is really kind of pointless to feed the dogs, but we want them to live even without us. Which, of course, with this being an early alpha, you see that there's invisible ropes to pull the sled with. Alright, looks like we've got actually a boar up here, so let's see what happens. We're going to, Let's go ahead and unequip our gun, and even though we've come so far in this game, I want to see what happens when you die. Turn the flashlight off. This is a boar, and let's see what happens when this thing starts to attack us. Oh! Oh, he's getting us! Ah, no, he got us! And we are dead, and he's eating our carcass as we speak. Alright, so I think we've seen a lot of the game, a lot of the content in the game. Keep in mind that it is alpha, so there are a lot of things that are going to change, a lot of things that are going to be added. Thank you guys for watching. Big thanks to the developer for letting us play this game early and doing a little video on it. And anyway, like, sub, and bye ya.